West Side Story, honored by an Academy Award as the best picture of 1961. For her performance in this film, Rita Moreno receives the award for Best Supporting Actress.
I can't believe it!
This is the color, the excitement, the drama of the Academy Awards. Hollywood honoring its own. This is part one in the story of the passionate love affair between an industry and a gold statuette called Oscar. On Hollywood and the Stars. In 1962, Hollywood produced 147 motion pictures, from low-budget quickies to super spectacles costing $10 million and more. This picture, Lawrence of Arabia, was voted the best of them all, the 35th movie so honored by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. Once a year on a spring evening, Hollywood expresses its love for itself in the form of a statuette named Oscar. Each Oscar costs $250, but can be worth millions in fame, prestige, and hard cash at the box office. It is awarded by a tough jury, one's colleagues and competitors. Many factors can sway their decision: emotion, popularity, high-pressure publicity, and most important, recognition of outstanding achievement. But whatever the reason, this faceless figure is a goal of all who work in movies.
Grace Kelly for the Country Girl.
Even in lives that are filled with fame and riches, this is a moment to be cherished. For an entire industry has said, this year, you are the best.
The thrill of this moment keeps me from saying what I really feel. I can only say thank you with all my heart to all who made this possible for me. Thank you.
As Hollywood measures time, the traditions of the Academy Awards go back to ancient history, to the year 1927. Actor Conrad Nagel is a founder and early president of the Motion Picture Academy.
The actual genesis of the Academy was completely unplanned, unpremeditated, and quite spontaneous. A group of us were having dinner with Louis B. Mayer at his house down at Santa Monica. After the dinner was over, three of us, that's L.B., Fred Niblo, the great and famous director, and myself were off in the corner talking about the latest attack on Hollywood. Of course, Hollywood was always under attack from somebody in those days. We were saying, isn't it unfortunate that there isn't some organization which represents the entire motion picture industry that can speak with a unified voice and answer some of these attacks? Well, we finally decided that the three of us would give a dinner a week from that night to a group of representatives of the entire motion picture industry and see if they were interested in forming such an organization. The dinner was given, everybody was most enthused about starting such an organization, and the result was that, oh, 9, 10, 11 months later, the Academy was born. First award for the best picture was given to Wings. This picture really made history, not only for the fine performances, direction, writing, and so forth, but for these special effects. first award that was given to an actor for the best performance of the year. It went to a German actor, and remember, this is not too long after World War I, a great German actor by the name of Amy Jannings. The second year, best performance by an actress was voted to Mary Pickford. During those first years, we had no nominations. This resulted, of course, in the votes being split up sometimes between 15 or 20 stars. And Mary Pickford won for her magnificent performance in Coquette.
Oh, Michael, if you only knew how glad I am to see you. Oh, please stay and talk to me just a little while. I've been going crazy about you. It seems that I can't breathe unless you...
George Arliss, who won the award as the best actor for Disraeli, provoked a great deal of discussion among the Academy members because Arliss had played Disraeli for so many years in the theater that he had a much better chance to perfect his performance and make it great in that particular picture.
I'll smash the bank! Parliament granted the bank its charter. Parliament came with right. That show is right at my bidding. Your board of directors will be swept away. Your shareholders bankrupt. The bank ruined and you disgraced. I am Prime Minister. I can do this. And if you don't sign, by God, I will.
The Academy Award dinner quickly becomes a major event in Hollywood's social life. And movie fans begin playing the annual guessing game, who's going to get the Oscar this year? Among the early winners are Janet Gaynor for her role in Seventh Heaven, co-starring Charles Farrell, and Norma Shearer for The Divorcee. In 1931, 10-year-old Jackie Cooper is nominated for the Best Actor, but loses to an old veteran, Lionel Barrymore. The only tie vote in Academy history sees two Oscars given the same year for Best Actor, one to Frederick March for Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, and another to Wallace Beery for The Champ. As the years pass, the awards dinners are held in plush nightclubs like the famous Coconut Grove. Today, in that same room, award-winning director and former Academy president Frank Capra recalls a special evening.
Well, this room has tremendous memories for us. Many emotional, dramatic things have happened, many funny things have happened. And I'd like to tell you about one of the funny things that happened to me. We were at a table over there, about 12 people, and where Will Rogers said, "Now we get to the directing award." He began to describe this young man that had come up from nowhere in motion pictures and had now reached the pinnacle. And everything he said applied to me, of course. And then finally he said, "And now, come up and get it, Frank." Well, I'll tell you, our table just went crazy. And I got up and said, "Excuse me." It was a long walk to the dance floor before I could go up to where I'd received the Academy Award. But I didn't care how long it was, and I stepped on toes and everything. It probably didn't hurt because I was walking on air anyhow. And I suddenly get to the edge of the dance floor, and I see that the spotlight is on Frank Lloyd. And he goes up and gets the award. And I stay there on the floor with a lot of egg on my face, naturally. And the longest walk I've ever had was coming back through those same people, applauding like mad for Frank Lloyd, and me trying to duck under their hands and get back to that table.
But Frank Capra soon makes up for that harrowing night. Within the next 5 years, Oscar audiences will see him win the Academy Award for Direction, not once, but three different times. In 1934, Capra's production of It Happened One Night becomes the first and only picture to win all five major awards. Best Picture, Best Script, Best Direction, and for Clark Gable and Claudette Colbert, Best Acting. As an Oscar is presented to Clark Gable, Claudette Colbert, who felt she could not win, is at that moment leaving for New York. While railroad officials hold the train, Miss Colbert hurries to the ceremonies and accepts her award. As the Academy Award grows in stature, so does the Academy itself. What was once a small private dinner is now Hollywood's most heralded event. And news of the Oscar makes headlines around the world. New categories are soon added to the award sweepstakes, and more of Hollywood's luminaries find themselves in the winner's circle. In 1934, 6-year-old Shirley Temple receives the first miniature Oscar honoring juvenile stars.
Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Cobb. Mommy, can I go home now?
Awards for supporting roles are begun with Walter Brennan in 1936. Over the years, he will win 3 Oscars, more than any other performer. In 1935, Victor McLaughlin wins for his powerful acting in The Informer. He shares honors with Betty Davis, and she is one of 3 stars who will dominate the awards during these years. She wins 2 Oscars. And Spencer Tracy is the only actor to win 2 in a row for his performances in Captain's Courageous and Boys Town. The third double winner of the era is Louise Reiner. At the very start of her Hollywood career, this sensitive European actress wins top honors in The Great Ziegfeld and the following year in The Good Earth. To cash in on her triumphs, her studio will rush her into a series of pretentious disasters. Bitter and disillusioned, she walks out on MGM and turns her back on Hollywood. In the brief span of 3 years, Louise Reiner's remarkable career comes to an abrupt end. She is 26 years old. Although the stars and their films generate public interest in the awards, the Academy also pays tribute to others. It honors the many technical crafts that form the backbone of screen entertainment, including special effects, costume design, film editing, art direction, set decoration, sound recording, and cinematography. In a brilliant example of Oscar-winning camera work, director of photography Hal Moore captures the shimmering beauty of Shakespeare's fantasy world in A Midsummer Night's Dream. For his work on Lost Horizons, art director Stephen Goosen wins another one of the less heralded awards. But it is work like his which brings to the back lot of a Hollywood studio the wonder and magnificence of Shangri-La. By the end of the 1930s, it is award-winning achievements like these that make the motion picture an art form of unusual scope and drama, and the most popular entertainment in the world.
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy. Yankee Doodle do or die. A real live nephew of my Uncle Sam, born on the 4th of July. I've got a Yankee Doodle sweetheart, she's my Yankee Doodle joy. Yankee Doodle came to London just to ride the ponies. I am that Yankee Doodle boy.
He's a Yankee Doodle dandy.
During the Second World War, many of Hollywood's most popular achievements are inspired by patriotism. For 10 years, James Cagney had been a rock'em, sock'em, tough guy. Now he wins an Oscar for his vibrant portrayal of George M. Cohan in Yankee Doodle Dandy.
Yankee Doodle came to London just to ride the pony. He is a Yankee Doodle boy.
Thank you.
During the early 40s, even the Academy Awards must yield to the demands of wartime austerity. The traditional white tie and tails and glittering evening gowns are exchanged for simple dresses and business suits. James Stewart presents Gary Cooper with an award for his portrayal of war hero Sergeant York. And Joan Fontaine wins an Oscar for Suspicion. The following year, Greer Garson is honored for her title role as England's gallant, Mrs. Miniver. Her director also wins an Oscar, but he cannot be here to accept. At this moment, Major William Wyler is on a bombing mission over Europe. After the war, Hollywood returns to the glamour and glitter of bygone years. Too big for any banquet room, the Oscar rituals are now held in resplendent movie theaters. But despite all the publicity and press agentry, the Academy Awards are basically serious affairs. One picture stands out above all others in this era. Samuel Goldwyn's The Best Years of Our Lives wins 7 Oscars. And to Goldwyn goes the coveted Thalberg Award. The film wins its honors for scenes like this one, with Kathy O'Donnell and Harold Russell, an actual amputee.
That's not loaded, is it?
Of course it isn't loaded. Don't you think I know how to handle a gun?
I don't know what to think, Homer. All I know is I was in love with you when you left, and I'm in love with you now. Other things may have changed, but that hasn't.
You want to see how the hooks work? You want to see the freak? All right, I'll show you. Take a good look.
I didn't mean anything, Homer. It was only...
I'm sorry, Luella. It isn't your fault. Go on and play with your friends.
It is a Hollywood truism that one big scene can be the margin of victory in the Oscar Derby. Such scenes are rare, and it takes a rare performer to carry them off, like Claire Trevor. In Key Largo, she wins her Oscar as the alcoholic mistress of a sadistic gangster played by Edward G. Robinson.
Tell you what, I got a proposition for you. Now, you sing us your song, you can have a drink.
Without any accompaniment?
Now, look, do you want a drink or don't you?
All right.
Well? Well, go ahead, sing.
Moaning low, my sweet man, I love him so. Though he's mean as can be, he's the kind of man, he's the kind of woman like me. Moaning low, my sweet man is gonna go. When he goes, oh Lordy, he's the kind of man, he's the kind of woman like me.
Give me that drink now, Johnny.
No.
Johnny.
Usually, a sustained performance is the key to an Academy Award. Co-starring with Stephen McNally, Jane Wyman speaks not one word in her award-winning portrayal of a deaf mute in Johnny Belinda.
First time a man kissed you, wasn't it? Be scared, darling. The guards found her. They caught a seagull once, had the same scared look.
Thank you.
accept this very gratefully for keeping my mouth shut once. I think I'll do it again.
The winner is Ernest Borgnine in Marty.
Perhaps the most unexpected victory in the history of the Academy Award is the success of Marty, starring Ernest Borgnine. A low-budget film, Marty is, nevertheless, named the best picture of the year. And Borgnine wins an Oscar in the unlikely role of a gentle and lonely butcher.
No, Ma, I don't want to go to Stardust Ballroom because all that ever happened to me there was girls made me feel like I was a bug. I got feelings, you know. I had enough pain. No thanks, Ma.
Marty.
No. I'm going to stay home tonight and watch the hit parade.
Are you going to die without a son?
No, I'll die without a son.
Well, Marty, put on the blue suit, huh?
Blue suit, gray suit. I'm just a fat little man, a fat, ugly man.
You're not ugly.
I'm ugly, I'm ugly, I'm ugly.
Marty.
Ma, leave me alone. Ma, what do you want from me? What do you want from me? I'm miserable enough as it is. All right, so I'll go to the Stardust Ball. I'll put on a blue suit and I'll go. And you know what I'm going to get for my trouble? Heartache. A big night of heartache.
By the late 50s, Hollywood is no longer the center of the film universe, and Oscar reflects the changing industry. In the Academy's 30th year, 7 awards go to The Bridge on the River Kwai. Based on a French novel, the picture is filmed in Ceylon by an American producer and a British director, with an international cast headed by Alec Guinness. The Oscar has come a long way from the time when three men decided that it might be a good idea to set aside one night a year. A night when those who make pictures could single out a handful of their own kind and say, this year, you were the best. Once a year, a closed all-night work session lights the headquarters of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. In the early morning hours, cameramen and reporters arrive to cover the big story, the announcement of nominations for the Academy Awards. By the appointed hour, the working press has been joined and outnumbered by a corps of studio press agents. Finally, all are allowed inside to learn and thus inform the world. In the next 6 weeks from now until the awards are given, tension will mount in Hollywood. For the nominees, both fame and a considerable fortune hang in the balance. An Oscar can be worth millions of dollars in box office receipts. The general public seems to be most interested in the personalities involved. And over the years, the Oscar Derby has provided newsmen with a rich fund of human interest. In 1949, John Huston received 2 Academy Awards for writing and directing The Treasure of the Sierra Madre. Huston's father had been nominated for a supporting actor in the same film, and now Walter Huston makes Oscar-winning a sentimental family affair.
Many years ago, I raised a son, and I said, if you ever become a director or a writer, please find a good part for your old man. He did all right.
In Treasure of the Sierra Madre, Walter Huston played a grizzled prospector. Aided by Humphrey Bogart and Tim Holt, his performance well merited an Academy Award.
I'm thinking we ought to give up. Leave the whole outfit. everything behind and go back to civilization.
What's that you say? Go back? Ha-ha! Well, tell my old grandmother. I got two very elegant bedfellows who kick at the first drop of rain and hide in the closet from thunder rumbles. My, what great prospectors. Two shoe clerks reading the magazine about prospecting for gold in the land of the midnight sun, south of the border, west of the Rockies.
That's your trap. Shut up or I'll smash your head flat.
I'll leave him alone.
Can't you see the old man's nuts?
Nuts! Nuts, am I? Let me tell you something, my two fine bedfellows. You're so dumb, there's nothing to compare you with. You're dumber than the dumbest jackass. Look at each other, will you? Do you ever see anything like yourself for being dumb specimens? You're so dumb, you don't even see the riches you're treading on with your own feet. Yeah, don't expect to find nuggets of molten gold. It's rich, but not that rich. And here ain't the place to dig. It comes from someplace further up. Up there. Up there's where we got to go. Up there.
Somehow, the unexpected has become commonplace in the Academy Awards. Crooner Frank Sinatra has to beg Columbia Pictures to let him play a supporting role in From Here to Eternity. Sinatra offers to do the part for virtually nothing. But his powerful performance astonishes the public and the industry.
Crew. Listen. Fatso done it, Crew. He likes to whack me in the gut. He asked me if it hurts. And I spit at him like always. Only yesterday, it was bad. He hit me. I had to get out. They're going to send you to the stockade, bro.
No, they ain't going to send me to the stockade.
Watch out for Fatso. Watch out for Fatso. He'll try to crack you. And if they put you in a hole, don't yell. Don't make a sound. You'll still be yelling when they come to take you out.
When Sinatra wins an Oscar as the year's best supporting actor, it marks the beginning of a brand new career. In 1948, Broderick Crawford is a highly respected actor in Hollywood, but he is not a major star when he plays a power-hungry politician, Willie Stark, in All the King's Men.
They tried to ruin me, but they are ruined. They tried to ruin me because they did not like what I have done. Do you like what I have done? Remember, it's not I who have won, but you. Your will is my strength, and I shall live in your right and your will. And if any man tries to stop me from fulfilling that right and that will, I'll break him. I'll break him with my bare hands, for I have the strength of many. Doctor, I'm very glad to see you.
Boss, does it hurt much?
Could have been whole world, Willie Stark. Whole world, Willie Stark. Why does he do it to me, Willie Stark? Why?
Crawford's performance brings him an Academy Award nomination, but he's a dark horse, up against the likes of Kirk Douglas and Gregory Peck, vying for the Best Actor Award. The impossible happens. Crawford receives his Oscar in one of the most startling upsets in the history of the Academy Awards.
Here is meine Wäscheliste. Here is my laundry list.
1963. United Artists, Lilies of the Field, tells the story of a construction worker who helps five refugee nuns make a new life in America. But this offbeat, low-budget film seems a poor prospect for an Academy Award, despite a superb performance by Sidney Poitier.
Schmidt wird mit uns Englisch sprechen.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah,
man.
Sure. Anything you want to know, just name it.
Was hat sie denn? Fragen Sie ihn, was Sie
wissen wollen. Wir können fragen, was Sie wollen.
What is named this?
Phonograph.
Phonograph. Gramophone.
Phonograph record.
Phonograph record.
Phonograph record is black.
Stove is black.
My skin is black.
My skin is black.
Her skin is white. My skin is black.
White? Weiss. White is weiss. Black is schwarz.
Black is schwarz.
No, we better get out. Come on, watch me.
Watch me.
No watch.
No watch. Shh. I stand up. I stand up.
I stand up.
I sit down.
I sit down.
I stands up, y'all.
I stands up, y'all.
The winner is Sidney Poitier.
Against the odds, in defiance of tradition, Sidney Poitier takes the Oscar for the best performance by an actor in 1963.
It is a long journey to this moment. I am naturally indebted to countless numbers of people. For all of them, all I can say is a very special thank you.
Among movie people, it's still the Best Picture Award that counts the most. For making a film takes the combined efforts of hundreds of men and women. And all of them have reason to be proud if their picture is adjudged the best movie of the year. Voted the best picture of 1963 is the United Artists Lopet release, Tom Jones, starring Albert Finney, Susanna York, and Hugh Griffin. And this lusty comedy also receives Oscars for its music, its script, and the superb direction of Tony Richardson.
Oh, my God.
I trust you're not harmed.
No, no, I'm quite safe. How can I ever thank you, Mr. Jones?
If I've preserved you, madam, I'm sufficiently repaid.
I hope you're not hurt.
If I have broke my arm, I consider it a trifle in comparison to what I feared on your account.
Broken your arm?
Oh, I'm afraid I have, madam.
What?
Here I have another to lead you home.
And so, the motion picture industry recognizes the finest achievements in its art, the Oscar, symbolizing a moment of greatness on the screen.